let's go over the situation again. We've got another parasite outbreak in the laboratory on the quarantine platform.
What is this?
No idea.
Damn it! What the? Shit!
We've sealed all the exits to keep it from spreading. No one's getting out.
Zombies?
One of the researchers inside managed to isolate the parasite behind the outbreak. He faxed over his findings. Code Talker's analyzing them now.
Why this new outbreak? Despite our inoculation, this is still unclear. Introducing the Wolbachia to the infected prevented symptoms during the last epidemic. The parasites lodge in the victim's throat, forming a mating pair. But the Wolbachia turns the male to female. Two females can neither copulate nor lay eggs.
That's why the rescue team went in with more Wolbachia. But the outbreak still isn't under control.
They should not be capable of laying eggs. Yet, we have a new outbreak. And the Wolbachia have no effect. I pray this is not some new strain. If it is,
then someone may have brought it here. If there's a spy running around.
For now, we must focus on discerning the outbreak mechanism. The cases show another alarming new development. It is now even more difficult to tell who is infected. The eggs propagate out of sight. No external symptoms. One who appears healthy may be dying on the inside.
What the hell happened in there?
Boss, I still can't raise the rescue team I sent in. We know how to proceed if we just knew how to ID the symptoms. Finding that out is part of your job in there.
Transmission from inside. Here's the audio.
It all makes sense now. I win.
Where's it coming from?
Unknown. It cut off before we could get a fix.
It all makes sense.
Think he means the parasite? No way to know. But right now, that's all we've got. Hopefully, he can tell us something. We'll have to close the tent behind you, boss. Don't think the infection's airborne, but...
But what?
Find the source of that transmission, boss. Find our man.
You never know.
So
can't swim. I can smell anything through the mask.
The rescue team reported that too. Said it smelled like ripe fruit.
We cannot allow the infection to spread. If anyone shows symptoms, you must put them out of their misery.
That hurts me.
What the hell happened?
At least you're okay.
What's going on?
I win. I'm no slave.
reset the transmission. Seems like he had a way of IDing who's symptomatic. But what was he trying to say?
Snail. Yes, of course. It all makes sense now. Do not let anyone showing symptoms get outside. As infection progresses, it triggers an overwhelming urge to get out in the open. That's the parasite controlling them. Once outside, the birds will feed on infected bodies, spreading the parasite on land.
Still people you haven't checked. If they're not infected, bring them out. Otherwise, Eliminate them.
You're insane, Snake! He was one of my men! You yourself said we're a family! Or was it all lies?
Survivor, unlock the door.
Sorry, boss.
dead because of you!
What? He's right.
They were on your side. I'm on your side. And you turned them all to ashes.
They wanted you to shoot. It was that or be burned alive. Come on. Let's get this over with. Wait.
Missile or
boss? I don't know how you do it. All I could do was obsess over revenge, doubting my comrades along the way. Even after all we've accomplished, phantom pain never let up. If anything, it just got worse. But you understood that from the start, didn't you? From the moment you opened your eyes in that hospital, you knew it wouldn't go away. And you've been fighting the pain and confronting your phantoms the whole time. Knowing full well the battle would never end, not till the day you die. I respect that now, more than ever. It's an honor and a privilege, Big Boss.
Thank you.
I have the report on the incident at the quarantine facility. Assuming the vocal cord parasite underwent a mutation. The only plausible explanations are exposure to some high-concentration mutagen or radiation. As you know, some of the staff at the quarantine facility were infected with the parasites. The Wolbachia prevented them from copulating, but the parasites themselves can't be removed from their host's vocal cords. Once you're infected with Skullface's parting gift, you're stuck with it. The researchers regularly used X-ray equipment to monitor the parasites in their throats. No problem there, they kept a close eye on the radiation doses. But that equipment didn't just give off X-rays. It was also emitting beta rays. Even though that's unnecessary for the scans. See, beta rays have far worse effects on DNA than X-rays. Meaning the only logical conclusion is that someone added in a beta ray emitter to trigger a mutation. Those beta rays leaked out from inside the equipment. Because the emitter was retrofitted, the shielding was inadequate. And the person who ordered and inspected the equipment was you, Doctor. That makes you the only person with the opportunity to install that emitter.
So now you're saying I sabotaged medical equipment for some wild plan to make the vocal cord parasite kill everyone?
Or maybe you thought it'd reveal a way to treat the parasite without using the Wolbachia. With that much to barter, I suppose some people would welcome even a pathetic cur like you.
Just stop it!
You'd have no shortage of buyers, but most would be happy with just the parasite. You wouldn't need to offer anything else. However, if that buyer already knew about the parasite, they'd also know that by itself, it's no... the bargaining chip it once was. To sell to that buyer, you need to throw in a bonus. A way to one-up it. There's only one buyer who'd be after that.
Emmerich, we record all communications on Mother Base. That includes radio transmissions to and from homemade devices. You've been in frequent contact with people in America. A private biotech company. A client of which is DARPA. And they are connected to Cypher. You made a deal with Cypher. You offered them a new parasite in exchange for your safety. This is the only place in the world where the vocal cord parasite still exists. And you used it as a testing ground. Tried to resurrect their bioweapon. But your plan to obtain the parasite has failed. Your bullshit ends now. And don't think you're leaving here alive.
Hours after exposure to the blood of a symptomatic colleague, I found myself making my way up the stairs to this room. And I am not alone. Everyone who's infected, we've all come up here wanting to get outside. I know full well I mustn't leave, given the possibility I'm infected. Yet, I can't contain this urge I feel inside me, like the alcoholic who tries to make any excuse for one more drink. Every step I took up those stairs filled me with this sense of bliss. I still have all my wits about me. It took no time at all to rewire the electronic lock and open the emergency exit. Then, just as I was about to set foot outside, I finally realized what was going on. Desire for freedom is not my own, but that of the vocal cord parasites inside me. They want the raven to feed on us, pecking us to death. Attracted by these sweet secretions, they have mutated to facilitate this. That sweet smell is powerful enough to attract even a species with such a weak nose. So, before the the parasite. Take complete control. I must. Most of the staff in here are already infected. At least, everyone I've looked at is. Infection with this parasite causes a high fever in the pharynx. I have modified a pair of night vision goggles to react only to this temperature range. With these goggles, you can identify who is infected. Other infected will, like me, feel compelled to make it outside. If the ravens get their meal, they'll head for land next. That cannot be allowed to happen.
The whole idea of the vocal cord parasites was that they'd only copulate once exposed to a specific language over time. The parasites infecting our men in the laboratory laid their eggs straight away. The larvae were eating their lung tissue almost immediately. What kind of mutation was it?
Those who were infected and cured still carried the vocal cord parasites in their throats. They were still there, but the males had been rendered female by the Wolbachia, and copulation could not occur, so we thought. But it is the Wolbachia that mutated.
Not the parasites?
You remember I told you the Wolbachia attempts to maximize its number of female infected hosts?
Yes, hence the male to female transformation.
Precisely. But other Wolbachia strains use different methods. Cytoplasmic incompatibility, killing the males, and parthenogenesis.
Parthenogenesis? Aphids. Aphids use that to reproduce via females only.
Very good. The females lay their eggs without a male present, creating clones of themselves in explosive numbers. Parthenogenesis was originally a means for an organism to take maximum advantage of abundant resources by increasing its numbers. Certain strains of Wolbachia force this to occur, to create more and more infected females.
And that's why our men develop symptoms in the blink of an eye.
Wolbachia causing parthenogenesis is common in parasitic wasps. Of course, the Wolbachia I introduced you men did not have this characteristic, but I believe the mutation, whatever it was, caused it to force parthenogenesis, the vocal cord parasites. The Wolbachia we used to prevent egg laying became the agent of limitless reproduction.
There's something else. The symptomatic infected in the laboratory all wanted to get outside, even knowing there was napalm waiting for them out there. You said the parasites made them act that way, but parasites controlling humans. Is it possible?
Parasites altering the host's behavior is a common occurrence in the world of nature. Long ago, the vocal cord parasites had this ability. But even I never foresaw that might control humans. Until I heard the things your man said.
You mean the researcher on the top floor? The bit about, I'm not a snail.
Yes. Among parasitic worms, there is a genus called Leucochloridium that uses snails as intermediary hosts. As you know, snails prefer dark, gloomy environments. But once parasitized by Leucochloridium, they desire to be in the light. And that is not all. The parasitic worms thrust themselves into the snail's antennae, making them swell to abnormal size. The snail, meanwhile, frantically wiggles its antennae as the parasite squirms inside. The swollen, wriggling antennae soon resemble caterpillars.
I don't get it.
It is so they can be eaten by birds. Leucochloridium needs
praying mantis that is host to a parasitic hairworm will dive into water and drown itself, just so the hairworm can lay its eggs in water. Rats infected with Toxoplasma gondii lose their instinctive caution and run right up to cats. Just some of the many ways parasites control the host.
But we're humans. Surely our minds are too complex for that.
I thought just the same. Free will is what makes us human. So it never occurred to me that the parasites could be controlling the symptomatic. But the mood, the will of a person can be easily affected by the balance of their cerebral substance. Take the Toxoplasma I mentioned. It does infect humans.